This is your boy Black Ice. We're live here with the Poet family. We are in Chicago on 26 and Calumet, and we're going to show you what's being done good in the hood. You know, we hear about the gun violence in Chicago. A lot of you who are outside of Chicago hear about young black males and young black people and Hispanic people and poor whites who are contributing to the gun violence here in Chicago. 9 murders on Monday alone here in Chicago, 71 murders or homicides in a month of July. So we want to bring you some good news today. Make sure you share this good news with the world about what young people are doing in Chicago. And I'm going to introduce you to a brother who is here. He's one of the founders of this garden, y'all, that young black people are putting together, and he's teaching them how to garden and grow their own food. So introduce yourself.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Steve Hughes. I am with Otis Fresh Market. Otis right there. Otis Fresh Market. Otis represents organic things in season. What we're doing here in the Bronzeville community here in Chicago is we're working on an agriculture economic development project where we're going to be trying to get young men and young women employed and growing food and selling food into the community. We're very strong in terms of where it comes to group economics. We know that this community want this type of project, access to foods, and we also know that they're willing to pay for this food. So we want to put our young brothers and sisters back to work in the agriculture industry. And just a quick thing, 1% black farmers in the nation, in the world. So we have a lot of improvement, a lot of wiggle room where we can start our own companies and feeding and empowering our community. So that's the most important thing, and that's what this project is all about. So Mr. Black, what I want to tell you about is right here what we're looking at is the very first beginning phase of our agriculture project, which is the African American Heritage Garden. Mm-hmm. What we had to do is we had to drop 800 tons of soil here in order to get the depth in order to grow.
800 tons of soil.
Yeah, we're looking at probably just a fraction of what the 800 tons is. We're going to be taking a walk of the confound to see exactly what it is that we're doing. But as you just saw, we got here, and I want to show you this garden. This is in a collaboration with the Green Corp Young Youth. They came in, and they're planting plants that are familiar into the black community. Plants like kale, onions, other things, collard greens and things of that nature. So when the community walks through this garden, they'll be able to identify plants and foods that they're familiar with, tomatoes, things of that nature. So right here, we're looking at roughly about a quarter acre of land in which we're starting to grow our African American Heritage Garden. And then right next door, we have the greenhouse.
Well, let's go over there and check out the greenhouse.
All right, cool.
Hey, say hi to everybody.
Hi.
We're letting them know about the good you guys are doing in the hood. Say your name, guys, and tell them how important it is for you to get involved in something like this.
Well, I'm Jamia, and it's important to, like, learn about your history. Mm-hmm. Like, where the food you eat comes from.
That's right.
Stuff like that.
That's right. And, you know, when they think about Chicago, when they think about young people, especially black and Hispanic people, they think about violence. We're looking at someone who's not involved in gangs, not involved with drugs, but involved with building your community instead of tearing down your community. What message do you have to say to your city right now and the young people who are out there who are doing things that is causing a bad light on our community?
Well, all I gotta say is find something better to do with your life instead of all this stuff. Just put the guns down, stop the violence, all that stuff.
That's right, that's
help
right.
Help us plant these plants.
She said, help us plant these plants, y'all. Yes, yes, yes. We got Otis awesome. In the building. Right. We got Poet in the building. Now, this is who I met right here while I was Ubering, guys.
Yep.
Tell everybody your name.
My name is Soji Perez.
Soji Perez, and yep. Why it's so important for you to give back to the community.
One of the major reasons of why I think people should give back to the community is to see, kind of like a garden, right? You plant a seed and you want to see it grow.
That's it.
So this is like a larger, I guess, manifestation of that growth that we want to see within our communities.
All right.
And it really starts with the youth and kind of getting back to those roots of becoming closer to nature and coming closer to, you know, our foods, because we've lost that connection, something that we've talked about here, through, you know, giving our power to governments or corporations that maybe this should be the background.
yeah, it should be. It should be.
Really had it there. But we should have those connections, but we feel like we no longer have that. And working at gardens, working at community gardens like this, mm-hmm. really gives you the opportunity to spread that knowledge and spread the knowledge and kind of continue to learn and grow together as a community.
That's right. Now I want you to introduce yourself and say a couple of words also as well. You're working out here with these young people as well. Tell them why it's so important for you to be involved.
Hi everybody, my name is Tony Andrina. I'm a coordinator with the Green Corps Chicago Youth Summer Program. Why is it important the youth to be involved?
That's right. Because we know what the alternative is. Either you're going to build or you're going to destroy.
Absolutely. There's a lot of different reasons why, I think, and that really gets to the core of it. But amidst those reasons, I think it's important that youth see connections in their community and that they make connections personally with people in their community.
Yeah.
So people like Xochitl meeting with people like Steve, that's critical for the youth to be able to connect these ideas, right, and to ground them in real world experiences like this. I think that's most important because it gives them the actual feel, it gives them the experience, they get their hands dirty, they touch the soil, they plant the stuff, they eat the food that other people have been growing, and it really is a way to close the loop, you know, between education in theory and education in practice.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think that's definitely the importance of our program.
Yes.
So.
Keep it going.
Well, listen, I think you guys are going to take us on the tour of the inside, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So we're going to go on the tour on the inside. Come on, guys. We're going to go on a little tour on the inside. So if you can, what I want you to do is come on the side of us as we walk and talk.
I'm going to get the rest.
And let's see if we both can be in the frame at the same time, me and you.
Yeah, okay. So what I'm going to show you is I'm going to show you a couple different varieties of tomatoes that we're growing. We're growing cherry tomatoes along, as you can see right here. Some are ripening on the vine. We also have green zebra tomatoes, which are these.
And what are they called? Green?
Green zebras.
Green zebras.
Yeah.
Now, why are they called zebras? I see the stripes on them.
Well, there you go. You've asked it. Yeah. It's because of the stripe on the actual tomatoes. And this is what one will look like once it's in this maturity.
Wow.
It's kind of yellowish green, and it has a green stripe, so it's called a green zebra tomato. So one of the most important things about these tomatoes are just the flavor of the tomatoes are excellent. There are so many.
Now, what's different about the flavor of this tomato versus other tomatoes?
Well, it's not more like it's not a mild season. It's more of a harsher flavor to it. And the other thing about it, if you put a little Italian seasoning on top of this, you can eat them just like they're cookies. A lot of people eat raw tomatoes because of the health benefits of the tomatoes, and that's one of the more important things. Everything that you're going to see in this greenhouse is going to be promoted towards some type of health-related disease, whether it's high blood pressure, high cholesterol, or whether it's high blood pressure, high cholesterol, or even diabetes itself. So it's very important that we start empowering the community by getting back eating non-processed food.
That's right.
And eating actual food that's grown from the ground.
Now, those of you who are out there on my blogs, on my TV shows and radio shows, Black Ice is always talking to you about alkaline foods and eating foods that are alkaline, which is foods that are above 7 on the pH chart. What we're looking at here right now are alkaline foods. And disease cannot exist in a body that's alkaline. So what we're talking about here is not only eating right, but helping to save lives and fight off disease as well. So not only are the young people in this community building up the community by doing something that's positive and constructive, but it's foods that's going to help life instead of take away life.
And that's a good point.
And it's hot up in here, y'all. It's like over 100 degrees.
Yeah, if it's 85 degrees outside, it's easily 100 in here. That's so you got to get you some shorts and a tank top like me, brother. But you made a very good important point there. One of the things when people are being diagnosed with all these type of disparities, high blood pressure, cholesterol, it's a deficiency in their eating diets, meaning that they're probably eating a lot of processed food and the body isn't processing it correctly and it's reacting to that. And that's how you become sick or ill because you're eating the wrong type of food. So if we can empower the community by getting them back to eating healthy like we did 50 years ago when our parents and grandparents weren't being diagnosed with these type of things. Mm-hmm. When you're getting 7-year-olds and 10-year-olds being diagnosed with high blood pressure and diabetes because they're eating processed food. Wow. When we get them eating this, we'll get them back. We'll get them
so
back
less McDonald's and more of this. Listen, we just had a group of young people walk up in here. If you guys can introduce yourself to us, some Black Ice from the Poet Organization, and we're going to put this all over the world. Because, again, we're going to change the image of what they say about Chicago, and it's going to start with you. So, young man, tell the people who you are, how old you are, and why it's important for you to be involved in this.
Well, my name is Joshua Davis. I'm 18 years old, and I think it's important to be involved in this because the reason a lot of people are being like diagnosed with all these diabetes and all these different heart disease is because, you know, a lack of knowledge. They're not aware of that the processed food that they're putting in their bodies is killing them inside. And also a lack of resources, like it's not around that much in the Black community. Mm-hmm. Or if you go to like Schaumburg or something, they don't have all the corn sauce and all these hot flames and things of that nature in it. Mm-hmm. They have like more natural food, and that's why it's important to be involved with this, so you can make yourself aware, so you can put more good food in your body.
And what's your name again?
Joshua.
Joshua is here. He's from Chicago, and this is the Chicago that we want you to see right here, brothers and sisters. Let's go to you, young man. State your name.
Mark.
Mark, why is this important for you to be involved?
It's important for me to be involved because, like, I like some healthy foods. Like, I used to eat, like, a lot of junk food and stuff. Now I started learning about these healthy foods and learn that some of these, like, you can make it similar to, like, junk food that you eat. Mm-hmm. I also know that like healthy food is better for you than junk food. Mm-hmm. Junk food make you sick and stuff. Mm-hmm. The government's using it against us, basically again our pockets. Mm-hmm. Like if we use healthy food and we're able to spread more healthy food out, like how we doing right now with all this, like we'd be able to help our community. We'd be able to do better. People would be like more healthier. There'll be less problems with people.
All right, young man, tell everybody your name and why it's important for you to be involved.
I'm Tyrio, and it's important for me to be involved because Chicago is like known for a lot of like fast food places and places with fried foods and compact foods that don't really have a lot of nutrition. But if you were to like break the cycle and actually eat fruits and vegetables, then you'd actually see an improvement in generations to come.
All right. We got a young lady in the building, y'all. Tell everybody your name and why it's important for you to be involved.
My name is Zoe, and it's important for me to be involved because, like, a farm like this shows that there's some easy access to healthy, fresh food in like an urban area, and like not a lot of people seem to know about that.
All right, and that's good, and we are glad that you are informing everybody who's watching around the world the best part of Chicago, not what we see on the news. So who's going to take me through a tour real quick and show me what we have up in here while the sun is behind the clouds? Who's going to take me through? Y'all want to take one?
Let's all do it together.
That's right, let's all do it together. Come on.
Over here, mostly what we have here, over here is your tomatoes. So right here in this section, we have your cherry tomatoes. They're really sweet, almost like grapes. Mm-hmm. So as you can see, some of these are starting to get a little ripe because once they're ripe, they'll get
which
that
one is ripe?
That reddish color.
Let
like
me
this
taste.
One right
let
here.
Me taste that.
Yeah, go ahead.
Let me taste.
Maybe, that one's better.
Maybe this one is better.
Yeah.
You just hold the vine, then you just pull it off.
I'm gonna taste this, y'all. This is food that's grown by these young people here in the community. This is delicious. This is good. This is delicious. This is good. Okay, y'all, come on. What else we got?
Come on, let me show you what else we got.
All right.
All right, we got some starter plants. These are baby sunflowers right here. They haven't matured yet, but you might be able to see some little small flowers on there. These are actually developing to eventually.
Sunflowers,
yeah. You can get sunflower seeds, all type of stuff.
That's what I thought about when he said sunflowers. I thought about sunflower seeds. So
yeah, you want one of these?
This is the plant. Yeah, I would take one of these.
Anybody need one of these? There you go, Tom. All right, so we got sunflowers here. And then directly behind me, we got more tomatoes. But you see a different style of tomato. This one probably developing to being orange. So this is a sun gold tomato. And right directly behind you is jalapeno pepper. So it almost looks like a jalapeno tree.
Anybody want to try this?
Well, they're not. They're actually banana peppers in there.
Banana peppers.
They're in their mouth. So if you do want to try
them. So listen, when you go to Subway and you get banana peppers, it comes from the tree. All right?
Exactly. Yeah. When we say we make them, we actually grow them. So that's the most important thing. Then over here, we have some green pepper, bell peppers is something that you're probably familiar with.
Green peppers and bell peppers, family.
Right here. So you see.
Oh, man, this is beautiful.
Yeah, they're beginning to develop as well. We're also picking out of here, so you might see a little vegetation, and we've been picking consistently. Then alongside the side here, you'll see different varieties of plants. This particular plant, and this is a nasturtium.
Nasturtium. Can I eat this?
Yes, you can. I want
nasturtium. Okay, I'm gonna try this. Nasturtium.
Mostly restaurants like that for salads.
Mm-hmm.
Now you're gonna feel it's gonna have a lettuce type taste to it.
And it's a little bit spicy.
Right. That the spice is gonna kick in later. So this allows you to actually put into your salads and not actually have to use pepper if you want to avoid that. Or you can put the pepper in there, but this is a nice, tasty little type plant. And as we work our way down here, I want to show you, we also have eggplants here as well. Here's some growth. You'll see an eggplant right here.
Did you guys see this right here? Eggplant.
Yeah, we got eggplants growing up in here. And then right behind over here, we have more tomatoes, and then we have basil. Again, now you're seeing the different variation of colors of tomatoes. So this is going to be orange. This is the orange tomato. And then right
you see below, the orange tomatoes? Okay, cool.
But then even right below it, we're growing carrots.
So you're growing carrots and tomatoes in the same?
Carrots.
Look at this, guys.
That's a nublet.
Carrots.
Carrot. So we're growing carrots directly out of burlap sacks. Then right below, we're growing Swiss chard. Swiss chard right here, which is almost like in the spinach family, very soft type of leaf. Before we even walk further, I want to show you something over here. We're actually growing honeydew melons.
Honeydew melon, everybody. Honeydew melon.
So right here, you're going to come in here. Let's see if we can find some vegetation.
This one right there.
Yeah, there's some down here.
Oh, wow. This is beautiful.
Yeah. So you see that back there in the back? That's a melon. See that big bad boy right there?
Wow.
So, and then we also grow an acorn. We're growing acorn squash. Over here, I want to show you this. So you get a feel for what acorn squash looks like. This is a baby, and this would be a mature type of squash growing here.
Now, this is called acorn squash?
Acorn squash. Right. And then here, we're gonna go back this way. I want you to turn around. I'm going to show you some greens and some cabbage. Collards. Okay.
You going straight or
we can go straight. Okay. So right here, you see we have red Russian kale, which is a kale, but it's in purplish in its color. Here, point to the plant. I want them to see that more so. My beautiful face. And then, what you call them? So we got kale growing, and then as you work your way down, cameraman, you'll see green kale as well. This is large vegetation. And then directly in the second outlet in the back, you'll see some collard greens with those gigantic leaves that are going on there. And then you'll see turnips. Turnip greens over there. There's also turnip bottoms, which will develop under the bottom of black folks like that. Mm-hmm. We eat that all the time. So,
okay.
Then right directly behind those tall plants over there.
The tall plants, family, the tall one.
Those are okra plants.
Okra.
Yeah, so we're growing okra as well. And then I'm going to show you a little bit of the herb garden that I'm growing in burlap as well. This is another type of leaf that the Latinos use. It's called preslin, and they put this in their salad. It's very delicious. We sell this at our markets as well. It's got a nice little flavor to it. Again, yeah. Mild flavor. Something you want to put in your lettuce or something just to kind of get you going, okay, to accent your lettuce. Then we also have here's another okra plant. That's going to be squash. These are herbs, so we're looking at thyme. Let me get rid of a couple weeds here so you can see it.
Mm-hmm.
Weeds love growing in here because of the fertile soil. This is curly parsley. This is thyme. This is basil that needs to be harvested. It's beginning to flower, so it's time for me to start harvesting a lot of this basil over here.
I smell it too, guys.
Then we also have spearmint and peppermint.
That's what I smell?
Yeah, well, okay. you're smelling the basil. Then you also have some
mint.
Yeah, you just take a smell off of that, or you can eat it. I know Ty's little sister loves this stuff. Mm. So we got some, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you can put this in the salad or put it in your water, whatever you want to do to kind of get it going.
I see a lot of people put it in water. Listen, I know the video is going pretty long, but hopefully you guys stayed around through the duration of the whole video. Again, I just want you guys to take one last look at this whole surrounding that we have right here. This is Black Ice from the Poet Organization. And you see young people being involved, getting involved. Otis, what's the acronym?
Organic Things in Season.
Organic Things in Season. Green Courts Youth. And we are all here taking Chicago back. It starts right here. You want a solution to the violence? You want a solution to the gangs? You want a solution to the problems that are going on in our community? Young people, it starts with you, and it starts with us as organizers who are out here mentoring and who are out here teaching better ways that we can live in Chicago other than what you've been seeing on the news. This is your boy, King of Poetry Black Ice, here with Green Corps and Otis, the Poet Organization. We out.